प्रेम. नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंट वृत्तिज वन बाय वन. द सेवंथ सूत्र पतंजलि एक्सप्लेन द प्रमाण वृत्ति. प्रमाण इज एविडेंस. सो वी रिसीव इंफॉर्मेशन थ्रू द फाइव सेंस ऑर्गन्स, आईज, इयर्स, नोज, टंग एंड स्किन. And this information is converted to knowledge with the help of conscious mind, subconscious mind, and brain. And then that is accepted as true or false. So this pramana vritti itself is subdivided into three. And that is explained in this sutra. Pratyaksha anumana agamaha pramanani. This is sutra number 7. So pratyaksha is direct evidence. Anuman is logic inference, and agam is through the words of the authority person. We'll learn one by one. The first is pratyaksha pramana vritti. That is, we experience the things, perceive the things through our sense organs. We see something, and what we see is definitely, we say, oh, it is correct. So we see something, and accept it. So it is pratyaksha pramana vritti. Our whole life is based on this. We see, we listen something, we smell something, we taste something through the tongue, and we experience this touch also through the skin. So whatever information is received through our senses, we accept it. So this pratyaksha pramana vritti is a regular process in our life. But Patanjali says that you have to control this. Why to control? Sometimes we get the knowledge through the sense organs, that is pratyaksha pramana. Many times it is correct, but I say it is not correct always. For example, we see the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. In the full day, we observe that sun is moving from east to west. So what is our knowledge? That sun is moving from east to west. That is what we observe through our eyes. And we say, oh, it is correct. But is it really correct? No. Actually, the earth is moving. But what we see, the sun is moving from east to west. So our observation is like this. Pratyaksha pramana vritti. But it is not correct. Likewise, there are many examples are there. But sometimes what we see, what we interpret is not correct. So knowledge received through sense organs also is not correct sometimes. And that is why Patanjali says you have to control. He doesn't say that you have to completely scrap these vrittis and all that. No, they are essential, essential part of the life. We have to follow them. But don't follow blindly. That is what Patanjali says. You control them. Check it up. Whether the knowledge received is correct or not. And one example I can give you. You may be sitting in the room. And you are waiting for your driver to get the car. So you look out the windows. You see a car. Your car coming to your house. So interpret, yes, my car is coming. But when the car comes near to the house, it doesn't stop there. It goes away. Why? Because it is not yours. The color is same. So you saw the color of the car and you interpreted that it is your car. But actually it is not yours. That you have confirmed afterwards. So initially this is a wrong acceptance. You may say, I am seeing my car through the eyes. But that is not correct. Colors may differ. That is why we have to control pratyaksha pramana vritti. Otherwise you will be in trouble. And to avoid that trouble or pain, you confirm it. Control it means confirm it. Let it Then the car come to near house and let it stop there, and then you'll find that your driver is there, and then everything is confirmed, and then you can say, "It's my car," so you can go with it. So likewise, we need to control pratyaksha pramana vritti also. Now second type is anumana pramana vritti. Anuman is a conclusion, logical conclusion. That means you receive certain knowledge through sense organs only. But it's of different thing, which you don't see the actual thing here. The same example we continue. You are sitting in the room only. You are waiting for your car, of course, with the driver. Then you listen some horn. You don't see the car. You listen the horn, some sound. And that is same sound as per your car. So you conclude, now this is a conclusion, because this sound is similar to my horn of the car, I conclude that this is my car. So my car is coming, this is my conclusion. But this also may be wrong, so many times it may be correct, but sometimes it may be wrong. The similar horns are there for different cars also. So car may be somebody else's. The sound of the horn is similar to your car. Right? By listening that, you concluded that because the horn seems to be similar to my car, I accept that this is my car, which is not correct. So the conclusion also sometimes may be wrong. Again, many times it is correct. You have to believe it. But sometimes it may be wrong. So you have to control. That is what Patanjali says, control chitta vritti. So this anumana pramana vritti also needs to be controlled. And a third component, a third category is agama. Now agama is a Sanskrit word. It means that it is a word of an authority person. Not general word. An authority person may be depending. Driver is an authority person to tell something about car. I'll give one more example. Normally, we believe all this agam praman. But suppose you want to plant an almond tree to get almonds. So you go to the nursery, ask that gardener, "I want an almond tree." That was a plant, a small plant. He gives you some plant. He says, "Oh, this is a plant of an almond tree." He may charge heavily because it is costlier. So you may pay a lot of money. Then bring the plant, sow it in your garden, give water, and your everything for years together. So you spend a lot of energy, money and all that for that plant. And after maybe 10 years, no almonds are there. Then some other expert comes and he says, "This is not a tree of almond at all." So what happened, you just note. Gardener of that nursery is an authority person. As compared with you also. So you believe. Whatever the gardener says, you say, "Okay, accept it." Then you pay the money, plant it, and spend a lot of energy, money, and time, and finally you come to know that it was wrong information given to you. So, agama praman is also needs to be controlled. Because many times it is correct, sometimes it may not be correct. And when it is not correct, it will disturb our life. If you want to avoid these kleshas, you have to control the vrittis. So likewise, he has explained the pramana vritti, three types, pratyaksha, anumana and agama. Now next vritti is explained in the next sutra. Hari Om.